was thinking in my mind. The ATF or somebody's gonna bust in the door right now because I'd never even seen that much cash in my life. I just tell people, man, I'm Joe Blow from Idaho because I'm like this old conservative fat Republican, but what you see is what you get.
You don't see a guy in a motorcycle or a hot rod without wearing denim. You must have denim. I didn't relate to A. Hardy or Von Dutch, so I started doing my own. They told me you went in prison. Yeah, nobody's perfect, you know how to do time. They say Jesus died so we can ride.
If anybody wants to get into the business, that's kind of the core place.
I mean, it's like being a gold miner almost. You pick and pick and pick and then find the nuggets.
Fucking fake. The vintage industry, Oscar Ross was a bunch of fucking fakes.
Ralph Lauren, Abercrombie Fitch, J. Crew, you know, big design companies, they're constantly lined up, you know, like a beehive to buy those goods.
You know someone's from Ralph Lauren, you're gonna charge them two or three times what you would charge somebody else?
Johnny's like, sees right through it, doesn't he?
A big portion of the vintage business is supported by the Japanese.
But the majority of Japanese customers are buying for themselves.
And they just buy and consume everything they can. I mean, they are more passionate about our Americana and our culture than we are of our own culture.
And Japan became the place because they were maniac about the vintage, the history of the jeans.
It's exporting of a culture. You're witnessing the Hollywood and Los Angeles culture being exported over across the globe.
And the jean was born in California. You design a new product, you call a stylist, and the day after, you have Angelina Jolie wearing your product.
This is the oldest pair of 501 jeans in the world. They date to about 1879. It's been appraised at over $125,000. It's completely priceless.
It's living with you, it's changing the color, it's taking the shape of your body, it's living with you.
They brought in this model and he put on this pair of jeans and he looked like $1 million.
It's like ripped and it's stained. And it looks like you ran through a field with pesticides all over it. And, oh, yeah, $500.
Whoever has the money is the guy that's gonna control.
He went to his fanny pack and pulled out $30,000 in cash and counted it on the bed.
I watched it go up and up and up, and the auction ended at $46,532.
Just that little stitch right there can make all the difference in the price of the jean when someone's buying it.
You'd make a little bit of money, but then you'd have a weekend where you just make crazy money.
How much do you think of that?
Too much.
They buy something, they place an order from you, and the next thing you know, it's all over Japan.
I actually would prefer you not shooting me looking at all these places.
I guess if I had an agenda or something that I really wanted to see happen more than anything else, then that would be bringing manufacturing back to the U.S. I traveled all around the world. I've ate $700 pieces of sushi in Tokyo before. That's the thing that makes it the adventure. You never know when you get on the road what's going to happen.